reduce urban development, we might see the reduction of wetlands worldwide. So basically, at some point in each and every one of your lives, you've seen firsthand the benefits that wetlands offer society, or if not, you indirectly benefited from some of the many ecosystem services that wetlands provide. And for this presentation, I referenced the environmental law and policy by James Salzman and Barton Thompson, along with the literary source. I also referenced some works, including EPA report on functions of wetlands, a National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration report, economic revenue from outdoor report, and also a New Jersey state legislature report from 2016. So whether it be ecosystem services, recreational opportunities, or economic benefits, wetlands offer a host of valuable ecosystem services that are both economically and ecologically important to our society. So first, I'm going to talk about some of the ecosystem services that wetlands provide. And secondly, I'm going to detail some of the outdoor recreational opportunities and economic development that wetlands offer. And then finally, I'm going to talk a little bit about what is finally being done to protect wetlands. So before you can fully understand the value of wetlands, you need to understand some of the ecosystem services. So wetlands, they provide a wide assortment of ecosystem services. They're all beneficial to society. Most notably, wetlands are very effective at biochemical cycling. And according to the EPA report function and wetlands of value, they are excellent storage and recycling centers for the elements nitrogen and phosphorus, which in high concentrations could lead to eutrophication, which is basically just harmful algae growth, as you see right there, that chokes out fish and marine life. And according to environmental law and policy, they're so effective that they can take out 80% of nitrogen and 90% of the phosphorus that's found in runoff water. So, and wetlands are also very good at storing carbon dioxide. And with increasing fossil fuel consumption, this is a very valuable asset, and this helps to reduce the effects of global warming. So, and most importantly, wetlands are very good flood control methods. According to a New Jersey State report from 2016, wetlands they prevent flooding by storing flood waters all the way up to the crest of a flood, and then they'll release them slowly over time, so it mitigates the risk of flash flooding. So just as important as these ecosystem services, wetlands are also known to a wide range of biodiversity that's both ecologically important and economically important. So wetlands, they provide many outdoor recreational opportunities, and they also support a wide assortment of commercial fisheries. And according to Southman and Thompson, wetlands, they are home to 1/3 of all federally endangered species on U.S. endangered species list. These species not only are ecologically important to the environment, but they bring in much revenue from tourism and ecosystem services. According to a report on the outdoor recreational economy, annually, Americans spend $646 billion on outdoor recreational activities that include hunting, fishing, and wildlife, among other things. And Southman Thompson also noted that wetlands are home to 50% of our migratory bird population, which use them for breeding, wintering, or feeding habitats. And these species alone can contribute $10 billion to the economy through bird watching and through hunting and other outdoor recreational activities. And especially coastal wetlands, they support 90% of the commercial fish harvest in the United States, which is a $208 billion industry annually. So wetlands are both a sanctuary for ecologically and economically important species, and with this distinction, much is beginning to be done to protect these areas. So since European colonization, there has been an estimate that the U.S. has lost 50% of its wetlands to an all-time low of 110 million acres. And during the late 80s, the government began to adhere to a policy of no net loss of wetlands, which means that they cannot destroy any wetlands without having some created in another place to offset that loss. And by the early 2000s, they were running a 30,000 acre surplus on annual creation of wetlands. Today, the federal government assumes the primary role of wetland protection, with the Army Corps of Engineers being the primary regulatory agency. And according to Southland Thompson, Section 404 of the Clean Water Act provides primary protection for wetlands. Section 404 states that no one can fill or drain wetlands without the approval of the Army Corps of Engineers through scientific evaluations. So this concludes a look at why wetlands are both economically and ecologically important and why we need to protect them. So whether it's ecosystem services, or it's recreational opportunities, or it's economic opportunities, wetlands provide a host of important functions that are necessary for our society. So today, the future of wetlands is uncertain. We can either continue down the path of continual destruction, or we can make a conscious effort as a society to restore these wetlands and let future generations